there's a new Home Depot now open on Maurice Avenue in Masspeth. And as home improvement projects go, this is a big one. Use the product locator on our app for an in-store map to find what you need fast. And check out our new pickup lockers. They make online shopping a breeze. Of course, one thing's not new, our everyday low prices. The Home Depot, now open near Maurice Avenue and Long Island Expressway in Masspeth. And always open at homedepot.com. The Home Depot, how doers get more done. There's a new Home Depot now open on Maurice Avenue in Masspeth. And as home improvement projects go, this is a big one. Use the product locator on our app for an in-store map to find what you need fast. And check out our new pickup lockers. They make online shopping a breeze. Of course, one thing's not new, our everyday low prices. The Home Depot, now open near Maurice Avenue and Long Island Expressway in Masspeth. And always open at homedepot.com. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, what are you guys up to?
Oh, little weeds, you know.
It's the Weedsman Podcast Nugget.
Zippity what?
Ready to drop the bass? Let's drop the bass.
Whoop-de-doo. What does it all mean?
All the random stuff that didn't fit in Friday's show you'll find here.
Oh.
Okay.
Hey, man. You got a joint?
Put a little bit of reefer smell on your boy.
What that mean?
Please, give me
like weed, all right?
It's an indictment of Fred Durst and his stupid red hat. I'm glad that band didn't last.
I was afraid for a minute.
I enjoyed it a little bit. I'm sorry. It was a guilty pleasure.
You're part of the problem.
The first album wasn't bad.
Yes, their first $3 bill, y'all, was good.
That was a good album.
Yeah. Hot dog flavored water sucked.
Monkey balls.
I haven't heard this in forever.
Me either.
Nate played this the other day.
Maybe as an adult, I may hate it.
I'm waiting for it to come in. Then yeah. I'll tell.
You know what makes me laugh about this? Is that he somewhat had some kind of cred to be on the Soulfly album.
Right.
Fuck.
Hey, you know, let me try something else.
There you go.
What was the one that I thought the riff was kind of...
Faith?
No, get the fuck out.
Oh, God.
The only song from that album anybody else remembers?
Yeah. Go ahead. I remember this one.
I thought I knew you. Took the time to put my love into you. Screw you, cause now you got me sitting in the sewer. I'm going on the roller coaster rides. See, I ain't forgot about the knowledge you retired.
See, shouldn't want to listen to this as an adult. Because now this sucks too.
I'm ignoring it right now. I've shut it off like parents when they have kids, they can shut them off. That's what I did.
This is your jam, right, Mikey B?
There you go.
What always bugged me, he'll get this, is it's the wrong chord progression in the turnaround. Wow, you look like you've never heard this.
He's probably avoided stuff like this.
You do have the...
Oh, this was... You were hanging out in warehouses, I think, when this came out.
And you're lucky you...
Oh, you ready? Oh, it's gonna get worse.
Oh, it's gonna get way worse.
They raped the song.
Say, it's wrong chords in the turnaround.
Yeah, totally.
Oh, ready? Oh, it's about to get more awful.
Your mind's about to get blown with awfulness.
Or it's about to go in a predictable place.
Like I heard. Yeah, it's horrible, isn't it?
When they came out, they packaged it as it was parody.
Parody rock?
That's why they said they covered it.
You're not Weird Al.
Millions of units later.
And you didn't even parody it. You didn't change any of the lyrics, as far as I can hear.
Right? No, they didn't change anything but the music.
Right, so what are you parodying? The arrangement?
Me?
Yeah, me.
Oh my god. I'd rather hear the Three Little Pigs song over and over again than this shit.
That song was awesome compared to this.
Oh yeah.
See, look, I don't get it. He's not good at rap. They're not good at metal. Like, I understand that this was seen as like this unique blend of music styles, but
yeah.
None of it is done well. That scratching is awful. Will you please just find a crossfader and just cut it a little bit? Like, what the fuck are you doing? That's the worst scratching. It's the worst rapping on these songs. You can't sing. You've got, from what I can hear, they've got a decent bass player, and that's the fuck it.
Yeah, you're about right.
Garbage music.
I remember when the DJ thought he was good. Oh. Remember when they did that shitty-ass album with the Speak and Spell? They did a Speak and Spell on one.
Yeah. No, but wasn't that DJ?
I was like, that's stupid.
Who was it? Was it DJ Lethal?
Maybe or no.
It's been done. There's actually
probably way better than
a Detroit techno artist has a song, Speak and Spell.
Hopefully, that, way better than.
I think it'll
probably
be better.
Oh. Well,
bye.
Since you mention it,
please.
Oh, Doppler effect. All one word. Some K's, maybe.
Maybe.
Not how you
think. Oh, you're right. There is a K.
Was this the dyslexic spelling?
From their album.
I love this track.
Jazam Cunts Twerk.
I love that shit. Who's getting notes?
Me.
It was blown up. Me too. Now it's me too.
But it was my fault for blowing it up.
I don't know where my phone is.
Oh, hey, I found out how come all of a sudden, shit started showing back up in Detroit dispensaries. Remember how last year there was like a 3-month period where all you could get was flour?
Right. Oh, the concentrates?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I know we talked about it, but I guess we didn't realize the impact of it. Because, shocker, we get high. And that's probably towards the end of the show.
Yeah.
The definition of usable marijuana was changed in the state of Michigan.
Oh, yeah.
It had only included flour until that point, and Detroit was the whole thing in the Detroit law was you can only sell usable marijuana, shit like concentrate,
right? Yeah,
edibles.
No, I remember we talked about
included
that.
In that.
Yeah,
that changed it. So that's why now in your local Detroit dispensary, it's game on. Ann Arbor had a little influx for 3 months, and now no one has to go past 8 Mile.
I like this.
Oh, wait. I think he's about to say that is incorrect.
Oh, really?
Yep.
There you go.
I like that.
I just had to hear the breakdown.
Yeah, that was cool.
I mean, you know, I know it's kind of a simple song, but man, in the middle of a DJ set coming through speakers right in your face, oh, God, that song would drive me nuts. And that the way he uses that stuttering effect on the Speak and Spell voice is it like gnaws away at my brain in this really satisfying way. It's like that Yar's Revenge shit again.
Oh.
And it's like something about the Yar's Revenge sound stuck with me so much because it tickles this part of my brain that I can't describe. Yeah. Well, even the Speak and Spell voice itself has that quality to it because it's so low bitrate.
Right.
But when you combine it with the weird effect, I it was probably just like a tremolo effect set really fast. Being modulated by a square wave to make it choppy.
Just don't go Speaking Bell by Helmet. I don't hear that one.
Yeah, who is that?
That's called Urban Dub.
Yeah. So you made a shitty trance version of a classic electro song.
All right. Well, sounds like Helmet.
Sounds less choppy than Helmet usually is, but what album was that from?
Size Matters.
Yeah. Well, I think nothing's mattered since Betty, actually.
Yeah, nothing's mattered since 1995, if you're Helmet.
Betty's a pretty good album, but yeah, I haven't heard him do anything since that I've enjoyed. This has got to be like somebody remixing the original. Who's credited as the artist?
Will Saul.
Will Saul? Yeah, I don't know. Hmm. Sounds like Detroit. Did you hear about one of the early investors in Netflix has got a company that's called
Netflix?
Netflix?
Betflix.
Netflix.
His name's Ted.
It's a porn.
Tedflix.
On demand porn.
Movie Pass.
Movie
Pass. Oh, I heard about this.
You heard about this shit?
You pay like a flat fee a month and you go to the movies all you want?
Well, I think there are some limits to it, but it's damn near you go to just about any movie theater to see any participating movie theater, excluding 3D or IMAX screens.
Boo.
For $10 a month. How do you possibly make money on that?
You just got to go to one movie and you've made your money.
Right.
Right.
Back.
So
as a consumer.
Yeah, so anybody who's going to see a movie once a month would be stupid not to do this.
Like, for real, when Manny and I go to the movies, two tickets plus popcorn and soda, it's like $50. Like,
now they got beer there?
Yeah, I've seen that. Those bars that they have in some pretty sweet.
Get an IPA.
I cheap out and I still am out. $30.
Oh, yeah.
For me and my two kids, we go to the matinee show, $5 a piece, and then they want some popcorn and soda.
Well, I still think when I go by myself, it's $30. Like when I'll be December, I'll be going by myself again. Because with Star Wars, I get, hey, have fun with that. So right. It's still like a $25, $30 trip.
I know that everybody says this about every disruption of some sort of industry like this, but how the fuck does that make money? I can't figure. I'm not saying I'm a you make it up in volume.
probably advertising.
Advertising.
What the service?
What does that mean? No, how do they make money off the fact that they're basically giving away a lot of trips to the movies, unless you're counting on.
From what I heard, they pay the movie theaters for the tickets, so the movie theater's still getting their money.
Right.
There's got to be some way they can sell advertising. Like, is there an app?
I'm sure there is. There's an app for everything.
But you wouldn't need the app, right? If you know your local theater accepts that movie pass, you're going to look at your local theater listings and see what they got. You'd only need the app to like register once. Like, I get what you're saying with the advertising. I just don't know where that would occur to the amount that would make a difference to offset that type of cost.
I'm asking Google, how does MoviePass make money? Here you go. How does the MoviePass business model work?
It doesn't.
I'm just kidding.
How do they make money? They don't. The company is subsidizing tickets using venture capital money. They're hoping that if they get popular enough, theater owners will give them some money.
Oh, so they're burning their own money.
Who's going to give them money?
Oh, come on. You know there's stupid people.
Yeah, exactly.
No, you said in the article, who's giving them? Who are they hoping will give them money?
Venture capital. They're hoping the... If they get popular enough, theater owners will give them some money.
Why would the theater owners give them money?
I mean, first of all, you know what? I'm on Reddit, so I'm just going to hit the back arrow. Nobody knows what they're talking about.
Yeah. Never take any sources for a minute.
Company hoped to turn a profit from subscribers who paid $30 or more per month, but didn't use the service often enough to justify the cost. That was their original business model. He's looking to lower it to 10. Well, this is the high price of tickets, not... Losey's is the biggest factor to blame for the industry's decline. He said the high price of tickets, not competition from Netflix or Amazon or anything like that. It's a big part of what's keeping people away. People really do want to go more often. They just don't like the transaction. I can agree with that. I would go to the movies more if it was cheaper.
Yeah, definitely.
Which means they would make more off of me in concessions.
Right, that's what I was thinking, where they can make their money.
Which is where their profit is anyway, where they make right?
The money. Yeah.
So, yeah.
You know how cheap, you know how expensive popcorn is?
I can understand if a theater owner was able to offset, was able to take a little bit of a loss and give some of that money back to MoviePass in order to make that up on concessions, that probably wouldn't be that hard. And how often are you really going to go to the movies? I mean, you might abuse the fuck out of it the first couple months, but then you're going to go like regular, right. You know? So 4 trips a month, if I go every weekend, paying $10 instead of $40 for my movie, right? And I'm paying $10, I'm paying $40 a month also in concessions. Oh, wait, so let me start over. $10 a month instead of $40, right? If I just paid for a ticket every time I went, that would be $10 a ticket. Average. They go up. So I see 4 movies, they made $10 off of me instead of $40. But that makes no sense, because that's MoviePass is taking that loss, not the theater. I thought I had it figured out, and no, it still doesn't make sense. I mean, if you just try not to figure out the parties involved and look at the math of... You go once a month and you spend $10 on a ticket and $10 at concession, right? Or you go 4 times a month, you spend $10 on movie and you spend $40 at concession. That's double the money going into the theater than would previously.
Right.
You go 4 more times, they get twice the amount of money they would normally. So somewhere in there, that math will balance out between the companies.
Shit, I'd buy it.
Well... Are you a Netflix subscriber?
Yes.
So this guy's not an idiot.
Yeah.
I mean, I go back to getting discs in the mail.
Oh, yeah. That, I would do that, actually.
That's how I binge-watched Sopranos. I was binge-watching before digital streaming.
I remember those days.
You get two
you'd
of those.
You'd buy some on DVD, and then you'd watch it.
Yeah, you get a whole season of Sopranos and just... I mean, you get like 2 or 3 discs at a time, but you got 5 hours on each one. You just cycle through them.
Pretty much I did that with weeds.
Pretty much I do that with weed.
That too. There was a combination of both of it.
Yeah.
That's what we need. We need a flat fee subscription service for cannabis. Like,
damn, that'd be sweet.
I just need to meet a guy and I'm like, look, I'll pay you $300 a month if you just come over and give me shit when I need it.
Right.
Control my cost. You control your flow.
Like a club.
Yeah. I mean, fuck, 300's too much. 200.
There is a subscription box that's out for...
Yeah. But you get like a set amount there.
It's like $500 a month.
Right. You get that once a month. So unless you're just the occasional smoker... That's probably not going to work out.
Listen,
for
man,
you.
I need weight.
You're going to burn through it. Yeah. You're like, how do I up my order?
Yeah. Can I get the extra order? The 3-finger order?
I must have heard this, but this doesn't.
Ah.
Play more ride. Scottish people.
Oh. They usually trim that intro out, don't they?
Yeah.
I'll
stay away from my back door.
Yeah, especially if you got this song on.
Well, tonight's the night.
Yeah.
Now, I like me some Rod Stewart, but only very particular versions of Rod Stewart, and this is not one of them.
I like the faces Rod Stewart.
Well, fuck yeah. I mean, it's hard to it's hard to be into any kind of garage rock or rock of that period and not like the Small Faces. That's a real name. That's not funny.
No, it's just the way
Faces, Small Faces. Just put it in your mouth.
Yeah. You dumb idiot.
Yeah. I mean, this shit is like better than the Stones to me. Maybe it's just because the Stones have been a little played out.
Wasn't Ron
Never
Wood
been
in
like
this
a
band?
Huge. Yeah. I couldn't tell you if he's on this track or not. I'm not sure. But I would imagine so. It sounds like him.
The song at the end of Wedding Crashers?
Was it?
Think so?
There was also Ooh La La was at the end of, what was that Wes Anderson film? The one that really hit big.
Rushmore,
thank you.
I love that.
I kept wanting to say Riverdale. I'm like, it's Riverdale. Not Riverdale.
You watch that?
I watched an episode and was like, that's not bad.
Yeah, I've heard good things about it.
And then it turns out not bad isn't good enough when there's so much good TV on.
Okay.
So
maybe didn't like it. My dad fucking watched it.
Really?
Because he's fucking. Because he actually is from the generation that read Archie comics.
Right. Yeah. I think it's cool, man. I mean,
it's definitely different.
It's actually in line with what Archie Comics are doing. They've gone through a modernization. I mean, a couple of years ago, they went back to number one, which Archie Comics was, I think, only beat by Sonic the Hedgehog for longest running continuous series. In numbering, I guess at some point they must have like started over. I imagine there was a lull in the 80s. I don't remember Archie being really big in the 80s. I always saw the digests, the Archie digests.
I used to read those.
Yeah, you get that shit at Toys R Us.
And the supermarket.
I'm like, well, whatever. Like, I read superhero comics and I don't get them from the toy store, okay?
Ooh! No.
Wow,
wrong.
Really?
I remember that.
Wrong,
so
internet.
I remember
wrong.
Riverdale's kind of an interesting show because it's kind of a murder mystery, too, that they're setting up. And the comic book, I got a couple issues of the comic book written by Mark Waid, because Mark Waid's he's a very good writer. He's written for decades many different types of characters.
Anybody I'd know?
Captain America is one of his big ones.
There we go. Yeah.
He's done more recent fantastic runs on Black Widow was good. Daredevil was really good. His take on the new Champions, not the new Champions, just the new version of the Champions, is kind of horrible. I think he's an old guy who doesn't know how to write young characters, and that's fine. I mean, it's not fine. I'm not going to buy the book, but like, I'm not going to hate on him because he doesn't know how to write young voices. He's going back to Captain America, so I'll probably check that out. But no, Archie's doing a lot of other things besides that. There's Afterlife with Archie.
I've heard about that one.
Zombies and shit.
Yeah.
There's the revamp of Sabrina the Teenage Witch, which is very gothic and quite dark in tone.
It's weird how they're trying to modernize.
Remember when it was Clarissa?
When what was Clarissa?
Sabrina the Teenage Witch. They had this is probably when you were dancing in dark warehouses.
That wasn't Clarissa. That was Melissa Joan Hart.
Yeah. There you go.
That wasn't Clarissa.
That was Clarissa to me.
No, Clarissa Explains It All was a different girl. I can't remember her name.
No, that was Melissa Joan Hart. That is where she came from.
She wasn't Clarissa.
Bullshit.
She didn't explain it all either. Sorry.
Erroneous!
My dad jokes.
Dude, I'm looking at her face. That's exactly what I was thinking of, and that's not her. I'm going to bring up her IMDb.
Get her.
Clarissa Explains It All.
Stop yelling at me.
Well, there you go. I'm totally wrong.
Wow.
You watched it. It's clearly a lot of, right there on the internet.
Teen stuff.
Snick.
Oh! Damn it. I was picturing Blossom. God damn it. This is the stupidest conversation ever.
Yeah, I was about to say this went weird for a minute.
Whoa.
Whoa. I remember that shit.
I just had to get that out, and then we can move on.
Nice.
Yeah, that was weird. Let's talk about adult shit, like
weed.
I don't know. Isn't Shawshank Redemption a good movie?
Yes. I'll agree to that.
If you like this show, please tell a friend. Please follow us on Twitter and like and share us on Facebook by searching for Christopher Media. You can subscribe to all ChristopherMedia.net shows for free on ChristopherMedia.net. Please make sure to rate and comment on all your favorite Christopher Media shows. Thank you in advance for supporting Christopher Media by clicking on the PayPal button and by clicking through to all the sponsors who support ChristopherMedia.net. Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net and thank you for listening.
Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net.
Are you ready?
To find solutions.
Ready.
For new opportunity.
Ready.
To take charge of the future. St. Joseph's College in Brooklyn offers a safe, flexible, and affordable education so you can be ready for what's next. And we make it easy to transfer, so you can stay on course to complete your degree. Attend an upcoming virtual transfer and adult enrollment day to see how. Register at sjcny.edu/vktransferevents.
Are you ready?
St. Joseph's College.
Ready.
Set.
Joes.
There's a new Home Depot now open on Maurice Avenue in Maspeth. And as home improvement projects go, this is a big one. Use the product locator on our app for an in-store map to find what you need fast. And check out our new pickup lockers. They make online shopping a breeze. Of course, one thing's not new, our everyday low prices. The Home Depot, now open near Maurice Avenue and Long Island Expressway in Maspeth. And always open at homedepot.com. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.